Hello and welcome to the User-Definable Fields tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll look at how you can create User-Definable Fields, and I'll briefly talk about what they are. So, User-Definable Fields. Well, in Clik, there's obviously lots of fields that we've already populated, but there will be some fields that aren't there, and this is when you might create a User-Definable Field. So, for example, we're in the CRM at the moment, I'm in Brewery Group, and in Classifications, there are some User-Definable Fields, and one of them is called Region. And as you can see, I've got a user-definable field here. So this wasn't in Clik. I had to create this and put it in. Now, there are other places where user-definable fields will be in as well. So for example, if we go to the jobs module, we go into the jobs and we go to the user fields tab, there are a collection of user-definable fields that I have created that are now in Clik Service. So how do we go about creating them? But it's pretty straightforward. We just go up to settings at the top here, go to settings again, and we go to user definable fields. We then click on user fields here and click on new. And then what we can do is we can type in a user definable field. So for example, in this case, I'm going to go switch on off. And in this case, I'm going to choose a type, and this type is going to be yes or no. However, I'm briefly going to describe what these other types are. So you can have just a text box. So for example, as you can see, region was just a text box. We can have memo text. Memo text is a lot of text. We can have a number, and then we can have date and time, and we can have a yes or no box. Now, this case is going to be a yes or no. Now, the next bit you need to do is say, okay, what module do you want this in? In this case, I'm going to make it available in equipment, and then I'm going to make it always show as well. Now, what does this mean? Well, available just means that you can pick that user field at any time for a piece of equipment. Always show will mean that it will always be on any equipment that you put onto the Clik database. So once you're happy with that, we're just going to press OK, and I'm going to show you now what's happened. So let's go back into the CRM. Let's go into sites. And let's just click on a piece of equipment. So we're now in the equipment database, click on a piece of equipment, and you'll now notice I've got my switch on off, and I can just tick it or untick it. And that is how you create user-definable fields. Thanks very much for listening.